Welcome to an example of cubic regression on the T84 graphing calculator. Here we're given data on a company's total sales where the data is paired, where we have the year and the sales in millions of dollars. We first want to create a scatter plot from the given data where we let T be the number of years after 2005. Then we'll perform cubic regression to determine an equation to model the data. And then number three, we'll use a model to make a prediction for the sales in 2014. Then number four, we'll use the model to predict when the sales will reach $5 million. But to begin, it's important to recognize that T is a number of years after 2005, so we're not going to use these values here for T. Since T is a number of years after 2005, and 2006 is 1 year after 2005, we'll use a T value of 1 for 2006. So we normally think of these as X values, but in this case, they're actually T values. We normally think of these as Y values, but in this case, we'll use S of T for the sales amount. So 2007 would be T equals 2, 2008 would be T equals 3, and so on. So when we go to create the scatter plot, we need to make sure that our x-axis, or in this case the t-axis, contains these values. We need to make sure the y-axis, or the S of t-axis, contains these values. To save some time, I've already created the scatter plot, which we'll duplicate on the graphing calculator. So again, notice how the t-axis does contain the values from 1 to 7, and the S of t-axis, normally the y-axis, does contain 1.6 through 3.7. But before we grow the calculator, let's discuss why we're using a cubic function to model this data. If we wanted to sketch a curve to model this data, it might look something like this. And notice how the curve does have two turns, or changes direction twice. It has one turn here and one turn here. Remember, a polynomial function has at most n minus 1 turns, where n is the degree of the function. And since a cubic function is degree 3, 3 minus 1 equals 2, and again, because the data has two turns, a cubic function should be a good fit for the data. Now let's go to our graphing calculator and enter the data. So we'll press STAT, Enter, clear out any old data by going to the top of the column, press Clear, Enter. So we'll go up to L1, press Clear, Enter, and now we'll enter the new data. Again, L1 will be T, so we'll have 1 through 7 here. L2 will be the total sales in millions of dollars. So we have 2.3, 3.1, and so on. And now we need to adjust the window before we show the scatter plot. So if we want our scatter plot to match our scatter plot here, let me go ahead and clear our function for a moment. We'll press Window and have the X minimum be negative 2 and the X max be 8 or 9. Let's go 9. And then for the Y min and Y max, we'll go from negative 0.5 to 4.5. And now to turn the stat plot on, let's go ahead and press Y equals, press up, highlight Y1 by pressing Enter, and go back down, notice how it's highlighted. So the scatter plot is now turned on. If we press graph, notice how this does look just like our scatter plot here in red. And now we can perform our regression, but before we do this, we want to make sure the diagnostic feature is turned on so that we can see the R-squared value, or the coefficient of determination, to see how well the model fits the data. To do this, we'll press second 0 for the catalog and scroll down to Diagnostic On. Which is here, so we'll press Enter and then Enter. And now we can run the regression by pressing STAT, right arrow once to calculate. Option 6 is for cubic regression, So we'll press 6. But now from here, we also want to store the regression equation in Y1. So if you have this version of the calculator, we're going to go ahead and select Y1 from here. If you have a newer version, you'll scroll down to Store Regression Equation and enter Y1 there. So we'll press VARS, right arrow, enter, enter. Now we have Y1 here. Again, on this version, we'll press enter. If you have a newer version, you'll scroll down to Calculate and press enter. So here's our equation where they're giving us the coefficients A, B, C, and D for the cubic function in this form here. Remember, we're using t instead of x and s of t instead of y. Also notice r squared is approximately 0.869. The closer this value is to 1, the better the fit. So this is a decent model, but it could be better. Now let's go back to our questions. We are going to round A, B, C, and D to 5 decimal places. So number 1, we wanted to create a scatter plot, which we already did. Number 2, we performed cubic regression, and this is our model where the values of A, B, C, and D have been rounded to 5 decimal places and subbed into our cubic function. We replaced x with t and y with s of t. So for number 3, we want to use this model to predict the total sales in 2014. But remember, we don't want to use this value for t because t is a number of years after 2005. So we're actually going to use t equals 2014 minus the base year. So we're going to use t equals 9. So to determine s of 9, we'll substitute 9 for t. Instead of doing this by hand, since we already have the equation stored in Y1, we can easily use the calculator to determine this function value. So let's go ahead and do that. Again, since the equation is already in Y1 as we see here, if we go back to the home screen, we'll now select Y1 by pressing VARS, right arrow, enter, enter, and then in parentheses we'll enter 9. This will evaluate the function at x equals 9, or in our case, t equals 9. So if we round this to 1 decimal place, or the tenths, the prediction would be approximately $9.7 million. Now this next question is a little trickier. We want to use a model to predict when the sales will reach $5 million, we're asked to round to the nearest year. So now they're giving us the total sales amount, and we actually want to solve for t. So we want to solve the equation 5 equals the right side of our cubic function. This would obviously be a very difficult equation to solve by hand, so we're going to solve it graphically. Since we already have this function in y1, we're going to enter the left side into y2 and determine the t value when these two intersect. So now we'll go back to the graphing calculator, and if we press y equals, we already have the right side of our equation in y1, so now we'll press enter and enter y2 equals 5. But remember, on the window, the y maximum only went to 4.5, so we do increase this past 5. Let's go ahead and change this to, let's say, 6, or let's make it 7. So now if we press graph, notice how this point of intersection here represents when the sales will reach $5 million. So if we find the x-coordinate or t-coordinate of this point of intersection, it will tell us when the sales will reach $5 million. To do this, we'll press second trace for calculate, option 5 for intersection, and now we'll just press enter 3 times. 1, 2, 3. So notice how the t-value we're looking for is approximately 8.0. So the solution we're looking for is t is approximately 8.0, but remember this represents a number of years after 2005, so to find the actual year, we take the base year of 2005 and add 8. According to our model, the sales would reach $5 million in 2013. It may or may not actually do this in 2013, but based upon this model, this is when it would occur. That's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.